Welcome to Easy Maths. In this video, we will be solving problems involving all the laws of indices. Now, if you are struggling, remember to go back to my playlist on laws of indices and watch the videos. Now, pause the video, have a go, and then we do them together. Welcome back. Now, in the first question, it's asking us to simplify w cubed plus w cube. Now in this case, we're not using the laws of indices. All we're doing is collecting like terms. If you need help with collecting like terms, you can watch my video on collecting like terms. So right now we're adding w cube plus w cube. So we're adding two lots of w cube. So our answer is 2w cube. Now in the others, we are using the laws of indices. So in this one, it's w cube multiplied by w cube. When we're multiplying same bases, we add our powers. So this would be w to the third power plus 3. So our answer simplifies to be w to the sixth power. Now in this one, we're dividing same bases, so we subtract the powers. So this would be w to the 3 minus 3, which is w to the 0 power. And we know that anything raised to the 0 power is 1. So this is 1. Now let's simplify this by canceling or dividing like terms. So e divided by e is 1. E divided by e is 1. And there are no more e's in the denominator to cancel with e's in the numerator. So now let's go to our f's. F divided by f is 1. So let's multiply. We have 1 multiplied by 1, which is 1, multiplied by e, which is e. And e multiplied by 1 is still e, and e multiplied by f is ef. So we have ef in our numerator, and if we divide it by 1 times 1 times 1, it is still going to be EF. In this one, 5 to the second power multiplied by 5 to the 0 power. Now let's do it one at a time. 5 to the second power multiplied by anything raised to the 0 power is 1. So our answer simplifies to be 5 squared. And if we're asked to evaluate it, then I know that 5 squared is 5 multiplied by 5, which is 25. But it did ask us to leave our answer in index form, so we do not need to write this. Okay, how about this one? We're using power to power law. So 7 to the second power to the sixth power. This simplifies to be 7 to the power of 2 multiplied by 6, which is 7 to the 2 multiplied by 6, which is 12. In this case, we have 3 to the 8th power multiplied by 3, and we know that if we see a number by itself or term by itself, the power is always 1. So let's go. Multiplying same base, we add the powers. Let's do them one at a time. So 3 to the power of 8 plus 1 over or divided by 3 to the power of 4. Now 3 to the power of 8 plus 1 gives us 3 to the power of 9, and we're dividing that by 3 to the power of 4. Now, when we're dividing same base, we subtract our powers. So that would be 3 to the power of 9 minus 4, which simplifies to be 3 to the power of 5. Now, in this case, we are finding the square root of 49 divided by 7 cubed. Let's do it one at a time. Now, in this case, in this one, the aim is to get everything to be the same base. So let's start by writing 49 as a power of 7, and we do it one at a time. So let us leave our square root, and we have 49 is the same thing as 7 squared divided by 7 cubed. Now, if we're dividing, same base, we know we subtract the powers. So again, let us leave our square root symbol and work what's below it. So that would be 7 squared minus 3, which simplifies to be 7 to the negative 1. Now we can simplify our square root symbol, which is the same as saying 7 to the negative 1 raised to the fractional power of a half. And then we apply our power to power rule, which is 7 to the negative 1 multiplied by a half, which is 7 to the negative 1 over 2. So this one is a bit more complicated, but then that's what is going to separate the grade 5s from the grade 4s. And the value of n. And these are, now in these questions or problems, we're being asked to find the value of n. Now let's take them one step at a time. So in this case, we're being asked to find the cubic root of negative 27. Then we raise that to a particular power and the value should be 9. What is that? One step at a time. So we could rewrite negative 27, the cubic root of that. That's the same thing. This is the same thing as what we have in bracket. We want to raise this to the power of n, and that should be 9. Now, the cubic root of negative 27, what times itself 3 times gives negative 27? Let's check. 3, negative 3. Negative 3 times negative 3 is positive 9. Positive 9 times negative 3 is negative 27. So our answer is negative 3. And that is being raised to the power of n equals 9. Now we want to start by writing 9 is a power of 3 because we need our bases to be the same. So that would be negative 3 to the power of n, and 3 squared is the same as 9. Now that our bases are the same, we can equate our powers. So we can make n be equal to 2. So n is equal to 2. Now, does this work? We can check. Let's check right here. The cubic root of negative 27 is negative 3. Negative 3 squared is the same as negative 3 multiplied by negative 3, which is 9. So my left-hand side of the equation is equal to the right-hand side, and that's exactly what we want. So n is indeed 2. Now let's move on to the second one. 3 to the n power divided by 3 squared multiplied by 3 to the 5th power is equal to 3 to the 4th power. We need our left-hand side to be equal to our right-hand side. So let's take the rules one step at a time. So 3 to the n divided by 3 to the 2nd power multiplied by 3 to the 5th power. Now, when we're multiplying same bases, we add the powers. So this would be 2 plus 5, which is 7. So now we have 3 to the 7th power, and that should be equal to 3 to the 4th power. Now, we're dividing same bases. So what do we do? We subtract the powers. So that would be 3 to the n minus 7 equals 3 to the 4th power. Again, our bases are the same, and that's exactly what we want. So now we can make our powers equal. So n minus 7 is equal to 4. Add 7 to both sides to solve for n. So n is equal to 4 plus 7, which is 11. And again, we can check to see if it is correct. So let us check. Let's check here. So 3 to the n, in this case, n is 11, divided by 3 squared multiplied by 3 to the 5th power should be equal to 3 to the 4th power. When we're dividing, same base, we subtract the powers. In the denominator, we are multiplying same bases, so we add the powers. So this is 3 to the 11 divided by 3 to the 7. Dividing same base, subtract the powers, so 3 to the 11 minus 7, which is 3 to the 4th. And that's what we want. So both our sides are equal. That's exactly what we want, so we know our answer is correct. Let's get rid of this. Oops. And then n, the value of n. So again, we try to get all our numbers to be in the same base. So we want to find the fourth root of 81 and then raise it to a power of negative 3. So let us rewrite this. So this would be 81 to the 1 over 4, and we want to raise that to the negative 3. And then that should be equal to n, 3 to the n. Now the fourth root of 81, what times itself 4 times gives 81? Let's try 3. 3 times 3, 3 times 3 is 9, and we know 9 squared is 81. So 9 times 3 is 27, and 27 times 3 is 3 sevens 21, 3 twos 6, and 2 8. So the fourth root of 81 is 3. So this would be 3, and that is being raised to the negative 3. That is equal to 3 to the n. So now that our bases are the same, we know that our powers can be equal to each other. So negative 3 is equal to n, or n is equal to negative 3. Now let's do the final one. 9 to the negative 3 over 2 is equal to 3 to the n. Again, our aim is to make our bases the same. So let's start by writing 9 as a power of 3. We know that 9 is the same as 3 squared. Or we could rewrite this using the root. So this is the same thing as saying 9 to the 1 over 2, or the power of a half, which is asking for the square root, that is being raised to negative 3. That's equal to 3 to the n power. The square root of 9 is 3. So this would be 3 to the negative 3 is equal to 3 to the n. The bases are the same, so we can equate our powers. So negative 3 is equal to n. Let's do it another way. First, let's get 9 to be a power of 3. So that would be 3 squared, which is 9, and that's being raised to negative 3 over 2 equals to 3n. Now, if we use our power-to-power rule, this would be 3 to the 2 multiplied by negative 3 over 2, and that's equal to 3 to the n. This should be to the n and not 3n, sorry. So 2 divided by 2 is 1. So we have 3 to the negative 3 is equal to 3 to the n. So n is equal to negative 3, or negative 3 is equal to n. So notice we got our same answer. So it doesn't matter which approach you take. Well done. I hope this video was useful. If you are struggling, rewatch each video on laws of indices.